Supermarket meat prices are on the way down, but it's not happening fast enough, according to the leader of the National Party. David Littleproud is tonight calling for an ACCC investigation into whether consumers are being ripped off at the checkout.
Adding a T-bone to the basket doesn't come cheap. Meat one item on the chopping block for shoppers battling the cost of living.
I haven't bought lamb for a long time.
We don't eat too much meat. Thinking of going vegetarian because of it.
Months after dry conditions sparked a drastic drop in livestock prices at the farm gate, relief is finally flowing through to the checkout, but movement is slow.
I've been hearing the news that it should be going down, and I'm waiting for that.
They're kidding us as always, and they're pretending that they're being good to us and they're making billions of dollars in profits.
Farmers receiving as little as $3.65 per kilo for cattle and $4.82 for lamb, while supermarkets charge as much as $30 a kilo for a beef rump steak, $11 per kilo of mince and $18 for lamb chops.
When you don't see that price being translated in the supermarket, it's really frustrating.
I am really sceptical that consumers are getting a fair deal, nor are farmers.
The National Party now demanding an inquiry by the consumer watchdog into meat prices at our supermarkets.
You need a tough cop on the beat that goes in and makes sure that the consumer and the farmer and the processor are being protected from big supermarkets.
But the meat industry fears it's local butchers that would become collateral damage.
No, we're not supportive of it because initially it already comes back to saying it's price gouging, and it's not. It's about quality of product that should be recognised.
Coles and Woolworths point out red meat prices have fallen in recent months and say they're influenced by a range of factors, including the cost of energy, fuel, processing and packaging. While the government claims it already has its eye on the supermarket giants through a review of transparency in the food supply chain, reporting back in June. Eliza Edwards, Nine News.